Hello guys, this is Revan from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 129. Poco takes a dig at OnePlus upcoming Note 2 smartphone. Poco claims a Poco F3 GT is better than Note 2. Both Poco F3 GT and OnePlus Note 2 are powered by the Dimensity 1200 chipset. Poco F3 GT is expected to be launched in India in the first 10 days of August. This is going to be a rebranded version of Redmi K40 Game Enhanced Edition. OnePlus has announced that it will be launching the OnePlus Note 2 in India on July 22nd. The company has confirmed that the phone will feature the MediaTek Dimensity 1200 AI processor. The key specifications include a 6.43-inch display, 50-megapixel triple rear camera and a 4500mAh battery. OnePlus India had made a tweet promoting the Samsung Galaxy Note 20 Ultra and its S Pen. The company quickly deleted the post, but not before people took its screenshots. It is possible that OnePlus India and Samsung India share the same social media agency. OnePlus has made this blunder mistake around the time when it's been heavily criticized on social media platforms for limiting the performance of the OnePlus 9 series smartphones. For those who are unaware, it recently came to light that the Snapdragon 888 processor in the OnePlus 9 smartphone is not running at its full potential in almost all the popular applications. The brand has accepted that it has limited the performance of these smartphones. In its defense, OnePlus say that brand has taken these steps to improve the battery life and solving the heat issues in the OnePlus 9 and OnePlus 9 Pro. After launching the Spark 7 series handsets in India, Tecno is now gearing up to launch Camon 17 series in the country. The Camon 17 series consists of two handsets, Camon 17 and Camon 17 Pro. A microsite for the Camon 17 series is already live on Amazon.in, so these handsets will be exclusively sold via Amazon. The brand is yet to reveal the Camon 17 series launch date, but the microsite reveals that these will be available during the upcoming Prime Day sales. Asus has confirmed a launch event in India on July 15th. The company is planning to launch something that is thoughtfully simple, aimed toward democratizing digital education to Indian students. This means that the company could unveil affordable notebooks and Chromebooks in India on July 15th. Asus has not revealed any official details about the product that it will launch in India later this month, but that confirmed that it is partnering with Flipkart for the product's launch. Asus announced the Zenfone 8 series smartphone, the Asus Zenfone 8 and the Zenfone 8 Flip back in May. Both these devices were supposed to launch in India alongside the company's global launch event, which took on May 12th. However, due to the second COVID-19 wave, the launch of the Zenfone 8 series was delayed in India. Now the Taiwanese smartphone is inching closer for the launch of Zenfone 8Z series in India. Xiaomi this year launched the Mi 11 Ultra in India. The flagship smartphone went on sale in India for the first time in limited quantities earlier this month. Customers who purchased the device will get a 55-watt fast charger in the box, this despite the phone supporting 67-watt charging. Xiaomi had previously said that it is working on bringing the 67-watt fast charging to India. Now the wait seems to be over as the company has teased the launch of its charging brick in India. Xiaomi's 67-watt charger is launching in India on July 12th. Amazon notes the upcoming two-day sale event starting at midnight on July 26th. The event will also see exclusive launches, but the company has not yet shared the detail. The upcoming Amazon Prime Day will again aim to empower small and medium businesses in India. Its annual Prime Day sale event will be held in India between the July 26th and 27th. The Realme C series may become the latest budget smartphone series and the first one under Rs 10,000 in India to get the 5G connectivity. Realme has hinted that while it commits to offering 5G on all of its smartphones priced above Rs 15,000, it also aims to offer the most affordable 5G phone in India to bring the service to the 10,000 price segment. The Realme C series is one that caters to the budget segment for the company in India. It is now believed to be the one that will get 5G support as a part of its next refresh. Redmi Note 10T design revealed in the new teaser image. The phone is set to launch in India this month. Redmi Note 10T will be the first 5G phone in the Redmi Note series. Several companies including Xiaomi, Micromax and Oppo have hiked their prices of their mid-range offering in the past couple of months. Popular mid-range handsets such as Redmi Note 10, Redmi Note 10 Pro and Micromax in Note 1 have already received price hikes. And now Samsung is the latest Android smartphone OEM to join the list, and it has hiked the prices of several mid-range Galaxy handsets. Now let's look into a new prices. Samsung Galaxy F02s for 3GB RAM and 32GB storage, the launch price was around 8,999. Now the new price price is around $9,499. For the 4GB RAM and 64GB variant, the launch price was around 9,999 Indian rupees, and now the new price is around $10,499. For the Galaxy M02s, for the 3GB RAM and 32GB storage variant, the launch price is for ₹8,999, while the new price is for $9,499. For the 4GB variant and 64GB storage also, the launch price is around $9,999 and the new price is around $10,499. For the Galaxy A12, for 4GB RAM and 64GB variant, the launch price is for ₹12,999, while the new price is around $13,499. And for the 4GB RAM and 128GB storage, the launch price is around $13,999, while the new price is around $14,999. Twitter on Thursday informed the Delhi High Court that it has appointed an interim chief compliance officer who is a resident of India and said it will make an endeavor to fill a regular position within 8 weeks as per the new IT rules. The new chief compliance officer will effect from July 6th, and a communication has already been addressed to the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. Twitter has filed an affidavit in regards to the compliance of court's July 6th order. Apex Legend fans recently got one heck of the throwback as the Genesis Collection event brought back to the original King's Canyon from Season 0, and the Skull Town made its way to the arenas. It seems like Respawn are really putting a lot of chips in arenas with the announcement of another event which will bring a brand new map to the arenas mode. The Thrill Seekers event, which kickoffs immediately after the Genesis Collection event winds down on July 13th, will introduce Overflow in the arenas mode. Yugot has an impressive track record of some pretty iconic cars that were matched with durability and endurance. The French car maker has revealed its newest hybrid hypercar that packs some innovative design. The company will debut the new hypercar at the Le Mans 24 Hours race and the World Endurance Championship in 2022. Qualcomm's first ever flagship smartphone carries a price tag higher than even the iPhone 12 Pro Max. It is priced at around $1,499 for Snapdragon Insiders, a community of Qualcomm fans managed by the company. That roughly converts to 1,12,047 Indian rupees. For the price, you do get a few more things other than the phone itself. The box includes a Master and Dynamics active noise cancellation, true wireless earbuds, 35W quick charge 5 charger, and a rubber bumper case and a USB-C cable. The smartphone will be retailed by Asus in multiple regions, including in India. It will commercially available in US, China, Germany, UK, Japan, South Korea from August 2021 and sometime later in India. According to the official Snapdragon Twitter account, Qualcomm will provide a 4 years of regular security update for Android software for the smartphone for Snapdragon Insiders and Snapdragon Insiders phone. Qualcomm is slowly but surely inching closer to the launch of its next-generation flagship, tipped to be the Snapdragon 895 processor. The Geekbench benchmarking data of the Snapdragon 895 in terms of single-core and multi-core scores that could be a muster. The Snapdragon 895 has managed to muster a single-core score of around 1250 points and a multi-core score of around 4000 points on the Geekbench benchmark test. In comparison with the Snapdragon 888, the difference in performance points to about 12% improvement for peak single core performance and about 20% overall improvement in performance. Krafton's latest offering in the Battle Royale genre on mobile is PUBG New State, an update on the original formula for PUBG with a fresh coat of new futuristic warfare that looks pretty interesting. iOS users for the most part have missed out the Battle Royale festivities, especially in India, with Battlegrounds Mobile India still not announced for the platform. PUBG New State on their iOS devices soon enough, with pre-registration set to start in August 2021. Android users have been able to pre-register for PUBG New State for a while now, and the game has gone through a rather successfully closed alpha test run. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.